Hi students, in this video we will cover the full chapter of electricity. The topics we are going to discuss here: electric current, potential difference, resistance, Ohm's law, resistance in series and parallel, heating effect of electric current, Joule's law, practical applications of heating effect and electric power. Our first topic is, what is electric current? What is electric current? Electric current is the rate of flow of charges or electrons in a unit time. The direction of electric current, it is always opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So the electric current we always consider as the rate of flow of electrons. Why don't we consider the rate of flow of protons or neutrons? Because in an atom, only the moving particles are electrons. The protons and neutrons, they are not moving. Because of the movement only, there is a flow of charges, and by that flow of charges only, electric current, it is produced in a wire or circuit. Okay, so the electric current we always consider as the rate of flow of electrons. The direction of electric current, it is always taken as opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. For the detailed explanation for the direction of current and the direction of flow of electrons, you can see the link in my description box. Again, we can define the electric current as, electric current is the amount of charge flowing in a unit time. By formula wise, we can write it as I is equal to Q by T, where Q is the charge and its unit is coulomb. T is the time in seconds. So the current we can represent as coulomb per second, but SI unit of current, it is ampere. So ampere generally we are using as the unit of current. This is something you should by heart about current. 1 coulomb charge, it consists of 6 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. Okay, so this number you should by heart. So an electron possesses a negative charge of 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. This number also it is better to get by heart. This is coming like 1 coulomb is equal to 6 into 10 raised to 18 electrons. Okay. So, 1 electron, how much charge? That will be 1 by 6 into 10 raised to 18. Okay, that is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, how the charges can move or flow in a circuit? We already discussed that current is the movement or flow of charges in a circuit. But how it is possible, the movement or flow of charges, that we are going to discuss now. Before that, consider two tanks A and B of water. And there is a pipe between A and B for the flowing of water from A to B. If I keep these tanks in the same height level, water will not flow from A to B. So I introduced a certain height difference here. The difference in height means basically it is difference in a potential energy which allows the flowing of water here. So in the same way, in the case of wire also, there should be a difference in potential energy for the flowing of charges. How it is possible? For making potential difference in a wire, we can use a battery which have positive and negative terminal. The difference in the energy level of positive and negative terminal allows the flow of current in a wire. So this difference in potential energy, it is known as potential difference. So what is the potential difference in a circuit? Potential difference is the difference in the amount of energy that charge carriers have between two points in a circuit. Otherwise, we can define a potential energy as the work done to move a unit charge from one point to other. Because the potential difference is the energy or it is the work done which is moving a charge from one point to other point. So V, this is the letter which we are using to represent potential difference, and W is the work done and Q is the charge. So V is equal to W by Q. This is the formula to find out the potential difference in a circuit. And the unit of potential difference, it is volt. Here you can see a schematic representation of a simple circuit and direction of current. There is a battery for the potential difference in the circuit. Here you can see the direction of flow of current. It is from positive terminal to the negative terminal, where the direction of electron flow, it is from negative terminal to positive terminal. We already discussed that the direction of current, it is always opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So it is very important, the direction of current, it is always from positive to negative in a circuit, where the electron flow, it is from negative to positive direction. Now we can discuss what is the relation between current and potential difference. We already seen that what is current and what is potential difference, and what is the relation between a current and potential difference, that we are going to discuss now. When the potential difference increases, current increases. When the potential difference decreases, current decreases. So we can write like potential difference V, it is directly proportional to the current I. Okay. And here we can discuss one example. In a circuit, I am using a 4 voltage battery. Okay, 4 voltage battery. Then the current, it will be, just imagine it is 2 ampere. Now I will change the voltage here and I am increasing the voltage up to 6 volt. Then the current will be 3 ampere. Okay. Again, I changed the battery and the voltage, now it is 8 volt. Then the current, it will be 4 ampere. Okay, so when the potential difference increases, the current increases. When the potential difference decreases, the current decreases. And again, consider the ratio between V and I. Okay, so here 4 by 2. It is 2. Here 6 by 3, it's 2. Again here it is 8 by 4, it's 2. Always the value is a constant. So V by I, the ratio between V and I, always it will be a constant in a circuit. Okay, so this constant we can rewrite it as R, and this R is resistance. A German physicist, his name is Georg Simon Ohm. He found out this relationship between this potential difference and current. That's why this V by I is equal to R, it is known as Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that the electric current flowing through a metallic wire, it is directly proportional to the potential difference at constant temperature. And we can again write it as V by I is equal to R. Here we can see a VI graph representing Ohm's law. Okay, x-axis, always it is represented here the current, and potential difference V, it is always representing in y-axis. From the VI graph, we can find out the resistance. Okay, let us check that. So the first potential difference and current, V by I, it is 0.4 by 0.1, it's 4 here. For the next case, it is 0.8 and 0.2. Okay, so the resistance here, it is 0.8 by 0.2, it is 4. And again, corresponding 1.2 by 0.3, it's 4. Okay, 1.6, 1.6 by 0.4, again it's 4, and 2. Okay, 2 by 0.5, again it's 4. So the resistance, it is always constant here, and we get the value as 4 from this VI graph. So what it means, the resistance is the slope of VI graph. Okay, resistance, it is the slope of VI graph. Now we will discuss the term resistance in detail. Resistance is just a value, or resistance is a ratio between potential difference and current? No, resistance is a measure which have its own significance in a circuit. Basically, resistance is a measure of the opposition to the current flow in an electrical circuit. It means in many practical cases, it is necessary to control or decrease the amount of current flow in an electric circuit. Okay, so for this purpose, resistance is a measure which is helping to oppose the flow of current in a circuit. So resistance, how it comes in a circuit? It is offered by a device, it is called resistors. Okay, so the resistors are the components which offers resistance. What is a resistor? It is basically a conductor only. Okay, resistors are basically conductors. Okay, but the conductors which has low resistance, it will be good conductor. The conductor which has more resistance, it will be bad conductor. Okay, so according to the value of a resistance, the current flow will be controlled in a circuit. Otherwise, by mathematically, V by I is equal to R, Ohm's law. Okay, so the current and resistance, it is in inverse relationship. Okay, so by the formula wise also we can say that when resistance more, current less. When resistance less, current more. Okay, and this is a simple circuit with resistance. And one thing I forgot, a unit is there for resistance, that is known as ohm. Unit of resistance, that is ohm, and we are representing it by a symbol like this. Okay, now we can discuss factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. The resistance of a conductor depends on nature of the material of the conductor, the length of the conductor, cross-sectional area of the conductor. Let us discuss each of this. Okay, whichever material we are choosing as a wire in a circuit, that material nature is very, very important, because some material will be good conductors, some will be bad conductors. Okay, generally metals are very good conductors. It can conduct electricity very easily. So the resistance will be less for metals. Okay, less resistance for metals. But if we take any alloy, alloy means mixture of two or more metals. Okay, so if we are taking the alloy as a material, it offers more resistance. More resistance for alloys. Okay, so whatever the material we are selecting, resistance depends on that material. Next is length of the conductor. Okay, if we are taking a very lengthy wire, we can imagine that current, it will take a lot of time to flow the charges through that wire. That means current flow will be very less. That means what? Resistance is high. So the resistance is high for lengthy wire or conductor. Okay, that means resistance, it is directly proportional to the length. Length is more, resistance it is more. And the next point, it is cross-sectional area of the conductor. Cross-sectional area means thickness of the wire. If the wire is much more thicker, then electrons can flow easily through that wire. Okay, if you are walking through a narrow street, it is very difficult to walk. But if you are walking through a broad street, it is very easy to walk. That's the same way electrons can move very easily through a thick wire, right? So the thick wire, it offers very less resistance. That's why electrons can move easily. So for thick wire, low resistance. Okay, so these all factors, it is affecting on the resistance in a circuit. So we can write mathematically it as resistance, it is directly proportional to the length of the wire, and it is inversely proportional to the area or thickness of the wire. So to remove the proportionality sign, we can multiply a constant here, and we will get R is equal to rho into L by A. This constant, it is known as resistivity. Okay, R is equal to rho into L by A, where R is the resistance of the conductor, rho is the resistivity of the conductor, L is the length of the conductor, A is the area of cross section. Okay, and basically this resistivity is a nature of, it is a characteristic of a certain material. Here it is a table which shows the resistivity for different materials. These are conductors, these are alloys, these are insulators. Conductors means generally good metals are conductors. So it has very low resistivity, okay, because it conducts current. Coming down, the resistivity, you can see it is increasing. Okay, for alloys it has better resistivity than metals, and insulators which has very high resistivity than alloys and metals. This is a simple electric circuit. We can use any of these components in any circuit according to the requirements. So these are some symbols to represent the components. For electric cell, we are using this symbol. This long end, it is positive, and short end, it is negative. Battery or combination of cells. Combination of cell, it is known as battery. Okay, so if the cell is of 1 volt, okay, just imagine it is of 1 volt, then it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, it will be 4 volt, like this. If it is of 2 volt, then here the battery will be of 8 volt. Okay, now plug key or switch. This is for open switch and this is for closed switch. Wire joint. Two wires are joined, then we will represent like this. Wire crossing without joining. Okay, if two wires are not joining or it crossing parallelly. Okay, so we can represent like this. Electric bulb. This is the symbol for electric bulb. And this is the symbol for resistance. And this is the symbol. Okay, if we are keeping one arrow through the resistance, it means variable resistance. Variable resistance, it's also known as rheostat. What is the difference between a resistance and variable resistance? Because in practical applications, it is necessary always to increase and decrease the current simultaneously. Okay, the resistors, it offer very less current. Okay, resistance will oppose the flow of current always. But in some cases, we have to increase and decrease the current. Okay, after increasing, we have to decrease. After decreasing, again, we have to increase the current. So there should be a variable resistance. Then only the current flow, it can be controlled there. And ammeter. Ammeter attests to measure the amount of current in a circuit. Voltmeter, it is to measure the amount of potential difference in a circuit. Now we can discuss two methods of joining resistors. This means in a circuit we can use many resistors, and these resistors we can combine in two different methods. That methods are resistors in series and resistors in parallel. First we will discuss about resistors in series. This is the circuit diagram for resistors in series. Here we are taking three individual resistors. Any number we can take. Just for an example, here we are taking three resistors. So the individual resistors are R1, R2, R3. Okay. So when the current is flowing through the circuit, here for individual resistance, current remains same. That is very important point about resistors in series. Okay, for individual resistance, current remains same, but the potential difference, it is changing according to each resistance. So how we will find out the equivalent resistance in this circuit, that we are going to discuss now. Okay. So, note the point, current, it remains same. Okay, that means I remains same in a series connection for individual resistance. And the resistance are what? R is equal to R1, R2, R3. And the potential difference, this is also changing according to the resistance. So, we can write like V is equal to V1, V2, V3. Okay. So, the potential difference total, it will be like V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, we can use the Ohm's law here. What is the Ohm's law? V by I is equal to R. That means V is equal to I into R. Okay. So, now we can substitute this IR in the place of V. Then it will be IR is equal to I into R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3. Now we can write IR is equal to I, we can take it out because it is common here, R1 plus R2 plus R3. I we can cancel here. Then R is equal to what? R1 plus R2 plus R3. So equivalent resistance in a series connection, it will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. So the equivalent resistance here, it is higher than the individual resistance because we are adding up here. Okay. So the total resistance, it will be higher than the individual resistance when we are considering. Now the resistors in parallel. This is the circuit diagram for resistors in parallel. Okay, so R1, R2, R3 are the individual resistance. We should find the equivalent resistance in a parallel connection. Here, opposite to the resistors in series connection, here the current it is changing for individual resistance. But the potential difference, it remains same. Or the voltage, it remains same for individual resistance. Now we can check the equivalent resistance for parallel connection. So here the potential difference or voltage, okay, V remains same. The resistance are R1, R2, R3. And current also, it is changing for individual resistance as I1, I2, I3. So, the total current we can write like I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. According to the Ohm's law, V by I is equal to R. Okay. From this, we can write like I is equal to what? V by R. And we can substitute this V by R in the place of I. Now the formula will become V by R is equal to V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. Again we can write like V by R is equal to V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. V here it will be cancelled. Then 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So the equivalent resistance for a parallel connection, it is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, here the equivalent resistance, it is decreasing than the individual resistance, because the reciprocal of the resistance we are taking for finding the equivalent resistance. And one other important thing, if two resistance are there, okay, now here we used three resistance. If the two resistance we are using, then parallel connection will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, okay. And again we can rewrite it as R1 plus R2 divided by R1, R2. This formula also we can use when the resistance are, we are using the number, it is 2. Then only we can use this formula, R1 plus R2 divided by R1, R2. Now we can discuss about heating effect of electric current. What is heating effect of electric current? Just imagine your fan is on for some time, or your iron box or mixie or any other electronic device. If it is on for some time, after some time you can observe that it is hot. Okay, that means the electrical energy current, it is converting as the heat energy. This is known as heating effect of electric current. When an electric current is passed through a conductor, the conductor becomes hot after some time and produces heat. This happens due to the conversion of some electric energy passing through the conductor into heat energy. This effect of electric current, it is called heating effect of current. And here we can use some formulas for finding the heating effect of electric current. Okay, so heating effect means basically the change in energy. Electrical energy, it is converting to heat energy. So there is a change in energy by time. Okay, so in a circuit, a change in energy by time, it is power of the circuit. Okay, so the power is equal to change in energy by time. And in physics, change in energy means work done. Both are same term only. Okay, change in energy, otherwise we can use the term work done. So the power, it is equal to work done by time. What is the formula for work done? W is equal to VQ. Okay, we already learned that V is equal to W by Q. From this, W is equal to VQ. We can substitute here as power is equal to VQ by T. Okay, from here we can choose this Q by T. Rate of flow of charges per time, we know that it is current. So the power, it is the product of voltage and current. Again, come to the formula. Power is equal to work done by time. Okay. So from this formula, we can write like work done is equal to power into time. Okay, and the work done, again the work done and change in energy, it is same. Here it is converting as heat energy, so I can use the letter H here. Okay, for the conversion of energy or the work done, I am using the letter H. And the power is what? VI, VI into T. Okay, so the heat energy, conversion in heat energy is equal to V into I into T. Again, we can apply the Ohm's law here. Ohm's law is V by I is equal to R. Okay, so instead of V, I can substitute IR. V is equal to IR. So H is equal to V IR into I into T, that means I square RT. H is equal to I square RT. Otherwise, we can write like I is equal to V by R from Ohm's law. So, in the place of I am substituting V by R. It will be V into V by R into T. Then it will be V square by R into T. Okay, so H is equal to I square RT or V square by R into T. This is known as Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating states that when a current I passes through a conductor of resistance R for time t, then the heat developed in the conductor, it is equal to the product of the current and the resistance and the time. These are some practical applications of heating effect of electric current. Electric laundry iron, electric toaster, electric oven, electric kettle, bulb filament and fuse. Bulb, filament and fuse, we should discuss some more in detail. So, the first one is bulb filament. In bulb filament, we are using a strong metal called tungsten. Okay, so tungsten has some specific properties like high melting point, and high resistivity. Okay, because of these properties, we are using tungsten material in bulb filaments. And one more thing is there about bulb filaments. Inside the bulb filament, we are not using the oxygen gas. Inert gases like nitrogen and argon we are using. Because tungsten is a metal. Metal will react with oxygen and the combustion or burning will be happened. Okay, so if we are using any inert gas inside the bulb filament, there will be no reaction with the tungsten material. So this is one of the common example for the application of heating effect. And other is fuse. Fuse is like a wire only. Okay, it's a wire we are using in all the circuits, and sometimes some excess current flow it is happening through the circuit due to some short circuit or overloading of current or anything like that. That time we have to protect the entire circuit. So we are using a fuse wire which has the properties like low melting point. Okay, these are the properties for fuse wire: low melting point and low resistivity. So when the temperature increases, the fuse wire it will be burnt, but the rest of the circuit it will be protected. So that is the function of fuse in an electric circuit. Our last topic is what is electric power. We already discussed some points about electric power, but some more points we should add now. Electric power is the rate of doing work or rate of consumption of energy. Okay, we already discussed this as power is equal to work done or change in energy by time. Okay, this is the basic formula for power. That only the definition of power also. Power is the rate of doing work or rate of consumption of energy. The unit of electric power, it is watt. And power is the product of voltage and current. We already discussed that. And here we can apply the Ohm's law. Okay, V is equal to IR, and here we are substituting for V, it will be I square R, and if we are substituting for V, it will be, sorry, I, it will be V square by R. Next important thing is, what is 1 watt hour? 1 watt hour is the energy consumed. Okay, 1 watt hour means the energy or work done. Okay, and it is when 1 watt of power is used for 1 hour. We can write like 1 watt hour energy, it is equal to 1 watt of power into 1 hour. This is 1 watt hour. 1 watt hour is the energy. okay, and the commercial unit is kilowatt hour, because 1 watt is very small quantity, so generally we are using kilowatt to represent the power. Okay, so kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of energy. Okay, and other unit of energy, it is joule. We know, again, this 1 kilowatt hour, it can be converted as joule. Like 1 kilowatt, it is, we know that 1000 watt. Okay, into 1 hour is 3600 seconds. Okay, so again we can rewrite it as 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. Okay, so the unit of energy, it is joule, and the commercial unit, it is kilowatt hour. I hope you understood the topics what we discussed in this video. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box, and you can see a link in my description box for the detailed explanation of what is current, what is potential difference, resistance, and the direction of current. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and share, and don't forget to subscribe the channel to get notification for new videos.